Hello everybody, once again I am with you with the concept curved surface area and total surface area of cone. Okay, so today's first problem is a circus tent is cylindrical to a height of 3 meters and conical above it. If its diameter is 105 meter and slant height of conical portion is 53 meter, calculate the length of canvas 5 meter wide to make the required tent. Okay, so here problem is given, a circus tent is cylindrical to a height of 3 meters. Okay, means base is cylindrical. Okay, so that tent will be like this. Base is cylindrical and its height is given, cylindrical to a height of 3 meters. Its height is given 3 meters. Okay, and conical above it. Okay, here conical on the top, it is conical, understood? Now if its diameter is 105 meter, diameter, what is diameter? 105 meter. This hole is given 105 meter. Okay, so easily we can find out radius from this. And slant height of conical portion is 53 meter. Slant height of conical portion is 53 meter, means this L. Okay, 53 meters. Okay, then question is, calculate the length of canvas 5 meter wide to make the required tent. Okay, we have to find out length of canvas. Okay, so first here what is given? Height is given 3 meters, diameter is given 105, so we can find out radius. That radius will be same for cylinder also and cone also. Okay, and slanting height is given 53 meters. So here in this case, here we need to find out curved surface area of cylinder and curved surface area of cone. Okay, once we will get curved surface area, then easily we can find out length. Okay, so first we will see, we will mention whatever given things are there. Okay, so what is given? Given things are there, height of cylinder is equals to 3 meters. Height of cylinder is 3 meters. Okay, then slant height L equals to slant height of cone is 53 meters. Okay, and what is given? Diameter. So diameter, from diameter we can find out radius. So radius will be 105 divided by 2 meters. Okay, 105 divided by 2, and that radius will be same for both cone also and for cylinder also. Okay, so that we have taken. Now we have to find out first curved surface area of this cylinder and curved surface area of cone. Okay, and we have to do the sum. So directly also we can solve that. So now I am taking here CSA, curved surface area of tent is equals to 2 pi RH, means curved surface area of cylinder plus curved surface area of cone, that is pi RL. Okay, first we need to find out curved surface area. So we have taken here 2 pi RH, that is for cylinder, and this is we have taken for cone, pi RL. Okay, so now from this radius is same for both the figures. Okay, and pi we can take common, pi and r are the common factors, so that we can take common. So I am taking that outside, pi r, what is going to remain in bracket? 2h plus l. Okay, so here directly we can put the values. So now here pi, what is the value of pi? 22/7 multiplied by radius, and directly we can take 105 divided by 2 in bracket, 2 multiplied by height of the cylinder. Height of the cylinder is 3 meters, so that we can take here multiplied by 3, plus slanting height is 53. So that we have taken, and here it will come meter square. Okay, so now here 2 ones are 2, 2 elevens are 22, then 7 ones are 7, 7 fives are 35. So what is remaining here? 11 into 15, here multiply by 3 twos are 6, 6 plus 53, 6 plus 53 will be 59 meter square. So this is the curved surface area of whole tent. This is the curved surface area. We can find out final product also, but this is not our final answer. So we will see what to do after this. Calculate the length of canvas 5 meter wide. Okay, 5 meter wide to make the required tent. Understood? Width is given. Width is given 5 meter. So we know that length into width is equal to area. Okay, so that area we will consider this. Okay, so now here we will use this, that is length into width is equal to area. So directly we can find out length. Length is equal to area divided by its width. Okay, so both the things are known. Area we have, that is 11 into 15, 11 into 15 into 59 divided by width is given 5 meters. Width is given 5 meters, so that we will take here 5 meters. So here it will be, this area is in meter square and this is in meter. So one, it will be cancelled. So it will be 5, 3 are 15. So this product 11, 3 are 33, 33 into 59, 33 into 59 will be 1947 meter. Okay, so here this is our required answer. Okay, so once again we will put a glance. What was given? Height of cylinder was given, that was 3 meters. Then slanting height of cone, okay, just now we have seen the figure. And radius, diameter was given. So radius we can find out, 105 divided by 2 meters. Okay, so we need to find out curved surface area. Okay, because question is like that, slant height, conical portion, calculate the length of canvas 5 meter wide to make the required tent. Okay, so in this case we need to find out curved surface area of cylindrical means base and top. Okay, so that's why we have taken here curved surface area of cylinder plus curved surface area of cone. So from that pi r we have taken common. What is remaining in bracket? 2h plus l. So here 22/7, and when you will do calculations you will get this product. Okay, but here we have to find out length, and we know that length into width is equal to area. So we have taken here length is equal to area divided by width. So this product and final answer will get 1947. Hello everybody, our second problem is a conical tent is 10 meter high and the radius of its base is 24 meter. Find the slant height of the tent if the cost of 1 meter square canvas is rupees 70. Find the cost of the canvas required to make the tent. Okay, the question is very simple. Okay, so here first thing we need to understand, that here we need to find out curved surface area of the tent. Okay, why curved surface area? Because canvas they are asking. In this case we need to find out curved surface area. Okay, because it will be open from the bottom. Understood? So first thing we have decided that we have to find out curved surface area. Okay, to find out curved surface area we use formula pi rl. We use formula pi rl. Okay, so we must know radius and slant height. But here we will see what is given. A conical tent is 10 meter high, means height is given. This is not slant height, this is vertical height, 10 meter high, and the radius of its base is 24 meter. Okay, 10 meter high. If it is like that, then its height is given 10 meter high. This height, vertical height, is given 10 meter. Understood? And radius is given 24 meter. Radius is given 24 meter. Understood? And we have to find out slant height. So slant height means everybody knows this is right angle triangle. So with the help of Pythagoras property we can find out this slant height. Understood? So here what we will get, we will see here, we have to find out slant height. Radius is given, radius is equals to 24 meter, then height is equals to 10 meter. So L is equals to what? L is equals to under root h square plus r square. So h, what is h? Height is 10 meter. So 10 square plus 24 square. Okay, so here we can take 10 square is 100 plus 576. Understood? So 100 plus 576 is equal to 676. Okay, so it will be 26. It will be 26. Understood? So here we got, this is 26. Okay, so slant height we have 26. So we can find out this now pi rl, that is curved surface area of this cone. So CSA of tent, CSA of tent is equals to pi R L. Okay, so here pi is 22/7 multiplied by radius is 24 and slant height is 26. So it will be this will give you curved surface area. But one more question they have told us, if the cost of 1 meter square canvas is rupees 70. Okay, so here we have to find out total costing. So cost is equals to, we can multiply here 22/7 multiply by 24 multiply by 26, and here we need to multiply by rupees 70. So directly here we can multiply, because this is our final answer. Okay, so here after product you will get your answer 1,37,280 rupees. Okay, so this is our final answer. What we have to do, we have to find out first slanting height. For slanting height we use h square, under root h square plus r square. So you will get 10 square is 100 and 24 square is 576. So it will be 676. Understood? So 676 square will be square root will be 26. With the help of this we have to find out curved surface area, and after curved surface area we need to multiply by 70, because 1 meter square costing is given rupees 70. So when we multiply, that time will get answer 1,37,280 rupees. Hello everybody, our next problem is, a tent is in the form of a right circular cylinder surmounted by a cone. The diameter of cylinder is 24 meter. The height of cylindrical portion is 11 meter, while the vertex of the cone is 16 meter above the ground. Find the area of the canvas required for the tent. Okay, so we will try to make here figure according to the given information. A tent is in the form of a right circular cylinder surmounted by a cone. Okay, surmounted by a cone, like this figure will come. Okay, and what is given here, the diameter of cylinder is 24 meter. Diameter of this is 24 meters. Understood? So radius obviously 12 meter. Radius of cylinder and radius of cone will be same. Understood? Then what is given, see, the diameter of cylinder is 24 meter. The height of the cylindrical portion is 11 meter. The height of cylinder is 11 meter. Okay, and what is given, while the vertex of the cone is 16 meter above the ground. Okay, while the vertex means this top vertex. Vertex of the cone is 16 meter above the ground, means this whole height of the tent is given 16 meter. Okay, so from this easily we can find out height of cone. Understood? So height of cone will be this 16 minus 11. So you will get the height of the cone. Now see, while the vertex of the cone is 16 meter above the ground, find the area of canvas required for the tent. Okay, area of canvas we have to find out. So here we have to find out curved surface area of cylinder plus curved surface area of cone. Curved surface area of cylinder is 2 pi r h. Okay, so from that radius we can find out, height is given directly, so there will be no problem. We can easily find out curved surface area of cylinder. But here for this cone, the formula is pi r l. Okay, so we need to find out slant height. Okay, so from that radius we will get easily. Okay, height we need to find out 16 minus 11, and from this two we have to find out slant height. Once we will get slant height, we have to do the sum of both the curved surface area of cylinder plus curved surface area of cone. Okay, so first I'm taking here whatever given things are there. So h is equals to 11 meter, that is, this is the height of cylinder. Okay, height of cylinder is 11 meter. Then diameter is given 24 meter, so radius is equals to 24 divided by 2, that is 12 meters. Okay, radius will be same for cone and for cylinder. Then height, this is height, height is height of this cone is equals to, how we find out, 16 minus 11 will be 5 meters. Okay, so this is 5 meters and this is, the radius will be 12 meters. So easily we can find out slant height. Okay. So now we are going to find out here slant height. Slant height is equals to what? L is equals to under root h square plus r square. So h is, what is h? Height is height of the cone. We are thinking about cone now. So that height we need to consider. That is 5 square plus radius is 12. So 12 square. So 5 square is 25 plus 12 square is 144. So it will be 169. The square root of 169 is 13. So slant height is 13 meters. So L we have now. Now everything we have, just we have to put the values and we have to find out curved surface areas. Okay. So now curved surface area of tent, CSA of tent is equals to curved surface area of cylinder, that is 2 pi RH plus curved surface area of cone, that is pi RL. Okay. So from that again we can take here pi R common. So that I am taking now pi R, what is going to remain in bracket? 2H plus L. So pi is equals to 22/7. Pi is equals to 22/7. Radius is 12. Okay. What is going to get here? 2 multiply by height is, what is the height? Height of the cylinder, that is 11 plus slant height just now we have, that is 13 meters. Okay. So it will be in meter square. So now here 22/7 multiply by 12 multiply by 11 to the 22. Okay. 22 plus 13 will be 35 meter square. Okay. So now here we can do here 7 5s are 35. Okay. 12 5s are 60. That is 22 multiply by 60 meter square. So it will be 1320 meter square. 1320 meter square. Okay, so this is very simple example. Here we need to do the sum of both the curved surface areas. Okay, thank you.